Basement of La Penta. This is WICR.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back to the Sports Wall. Jersey Joe back here, and obviously El Clasico. World Soccer is starting to kind of get back into shape. The seasons will really all be here before we know it. I think the Premier League is really maybe 4 weeks away from starting, but El Clasico is just, in La Liga, is just the cream of the crop. I mean, when you stack up the most important and most just inspiring, exciting, use whatever words you want to, sporting events in the world, El Clasico to me is probably right behind the Super Bowl in terms of just pure, incredible sights, sounds, just the meaning of the game. It's really indescribable, and I really would commend anyone who's just never really even taken an interest in soccer. If you put El Clasico on for 5 minutes and you look around the stadiums, you hear the intensity of the crowd, you watch the facial expressions of the players, there's really nothing like it. And it really, El Clasico, obviously we get two of them every year. We get one at the Bernabeu where Real Madrid plays. We get one at Camp Nou where Barcelona plays. It really reminds me of kind of, we all have our favorite movies out. We all have different ones that connect with us in different ways. And I think when we finish those movies, there's always a little bit of a sad tone because there's really not a feeling like experiencing that movie for the first time. Once you see, you watch it over and over again, but there's never really that expression where you can recapture how you felt experiencing that movie for the first time. For me, I mean, look, there's tons, but I could use The Dark Knight as an example for one. I mean, when I first saw The Dark Knight, I really think that it changed the way that I looked at film and at movies. And then after I saw it after that, obviously it always holds up. It always has a special place in my heart. But I don't think you could ever recapture the meaning that it had when you're experiencing everything is brand new. Every frame, every character, every line, every dialogue, it all is new. And recreating that, recapturing that is almost impossible. But El Clasico is like getting that movie that is more special to you than anything, and it's brand new every single time. And I think that's one of the most special things about it, is just each time it's a new chapter, every single one, and the intensity, the meaning of the games never wavers. And honestly, these are usually the games that determine who's going to win the La Liga title. I mean, you look at the last couple. It's last year, obviously this season we had Barcelona. The year before that, Atletico Madrid, Barcelona, Real Madrid, Barcelona, Barcelona, Barcelona. So, I mean, look, there's always those people who just kind of always joke that La Liga is always a two-way race between these two football giants, and it kind of is. In these two games, to add any more excitement to it, these are the two games that really will determine who the winner of La Liga is. It really changed last year. Obviously, Barcelona, the structure was kind of the same last year. The first one was at the Bernabeu, and then later in the season, right after we got back from spring break, there was the second one at Camp Nou. It's kind of the same this time as well. And that's really one of the points. Whoever is hotter going into that game, the second El Clasico last year, Barcelona, people forget it with all the success that they had. There was a little rough patch. There was the rift between Luis Enrique and the players. But then really after New Year, they went on that 13-game winning streak. Things really started to pick up for them. They went into the second El Clasico. They come out winning 2-1, and that was kind of what spearheaded them to the rest of their season, obviously capturing the three most important trophies you could have wanted: Copa del Rey, La Liga title, the Champions League title. So I think next year, I'm going to obviously have my shows where I'm going to pick all the winners of the respective leagues. But, I mean, if I had to pick today, I think Barcelona will recapture and defend their title. I think they will win it again next year. I just think right now with Luis Enrique, now that I think him and the players are on the same page and they kind of have that mutual understanding of what they expect from one another, I think that was the biggest rift last year, and that certainly has gotten much, much better. And the core of them, though, is just Suarez, Neymar, and then Messi. The bond that they all share on the field, the way that they're unselfish, the way that they make each other and everybody else around them better is the main reason why I just don't think Barcelona will not win the title again next year. And I just think right now, the way that they play is just too much to handle. Now, Real Madrid's going to be better, I think. I'm not 100% sure because there is a lot of changes on their front as well. Obviously, the legendary goalkeeper, Casillas, is now gone. You have a new manager there in Rafa Benitez. So there is change coming to them as well. But I think right now, the foundation is there for Barcelona. It's kind of funny. You always start the morning, you look at the stories, which ones you're going to lead off with. And obviously, look, this might not be the most important one, but I don't think that there was any other story that got me more excited. Because when you see the dates of El Clasico, you think of the sights of the stadiums. You think of the chants that you hear coming out of the crowds. You think of Messi and Ronaldo going back and forth with one another. There really is an indescribable feeling to it. And I remember the first one that I ever saw, and you come out of it, and I think you're just kind of almost in a different place, because it's just almost an unearthly experience when you see it and you hear it. I mean, and obviously, beIN Sports does such a good job with their coverage. When you add Ray Hudson, an announcer like that who is true and true, and almost as diehard of a fan as any of us are, calling the game, the tone that he sets, along with the crowd, along with all the players, and the meaning of these matchups, it just all makes for something that's almost indescribable, something that rivals the Super Bowl in every conceivable way. I mean, these games are as heavyweight bouts as there will ever be, and it just makes icing on top of the cake that we have Ronaldo always going up against Messi, the two best players in the world on both of those clubs. There is no way you can properly describe just the awesomeness and the magisterial nature of the El Clasico matchups. But we do have our dates. Obviously, I put them in my calendar as soon as this morning started. November 8th, the first one, that's a Saturday. April 3rd, the second one. Again, the first one is going to be at the Bernabeu, November 8th. It's a Saturday, Camp Nou. The second one, April 3rd. And I do think that it's interesting who has the second one compared to who has the first one, because when we look at the way that the La Liga season turned out last year, Barcelona lost the first match at the Bernabeu, but Barcelona and Real Madrid could not have gone in different directions. I mean, they played each other early, very early last year, and the way that both clubs kind of came out of that could not have been more different. Real Madrid certainly had their difficulties, had their rough patches. Barcelona got theirs out of the way earlier, and they got their second El Clasico in the perfect time for them. Real Madrid was in a little bit of a slump, and then Barcelona was just on the rise. Whoever has that second matchup, really, I think I would rather have the second one on my turf than having the first one away. I'd like to get that one out of the way early, because I know I'm going to be a different club by the time I get to that second one. And that's always what happens. Barcelona, I do think, though, they get the second one at their place. And it's kind of, now, obviously, the first one is much later in the year this year than the first one was last year. I think the first one last year, I don't want to be wrong, but I think it was either late September or early October, I want to say. I think it was early, the middle of October or the later half of October, something around there, though. And then obviously you had the second one around spring break time when we just were coming back. So it all makes for an interesting conversation, I think, for the audience more than anything. I mean, what does El Clasico mean to you? Even if you're not a Real Madrid supporter, you're not a Barcelona supporter, just being a fan of sports, I don't know if I could compare to anything aside from the Super Bowl. And even in the Super Bowl, I don't know if there's anything more exciting than El Clasico, only because in the Super Bowl, we get the zillions of commercials and everything. El Clasico is just nonstop, obviously, because it's the way soccer is. There's just no commercials. You just get nonstop hit with all this energy, all this excitement, all this craziness at once, and it just, there's nothing that you can describe it like. It just, it really is just unparalleled in the world of sports. But that is going to do it for this segment. Coming back, college football time. Oh my goodness, college football is right around the corner. And speaking of corners, we are all about college football corner on this show. So don't go anywhere. We will be right back with plenty of college football to talk about. Don't go anywhere.